Hey, Lynn. Lynn. Can you go on mute? Lynn, hello, Lynn.
Yes.
Can you mute, please?
Okay, I'm sorry.
That's okay. Sounded like there was an army run going through your kitchen. Thank you.
Is this the real life? Is this agility? Caught in a backlog, no escape from BI planning. Open your eyes, look at the scrum board and see. I'm just a poor PO. I need some sympathy. Because it's story scum, story scum. Feel the wrath of version one. Anyway, the app it goes. Customer feedback matters to me. To me. Mama, just drop waterfalls with infrequent deliveries. Consumers start to scream.
Mama, go pet chess beyond. But now you've gone and thrown it all away.
Mama!
Fibonacci, will you do the fandango? Bird that chance of frightening, very, very frightening me.
Manifesto,
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 manifesto, Figaro.
Portfolio.
I'm just a product owner, nobody loves me.
She's just a product owner from a small scrum tin. Swear in the life from it, this way I did.
Did he scrum? Did he stand up? Are they all the same?
Team member.
But they are all the same.
All the same.
Team member.
So what is in the name?
In the name.
Team member.
So it's all in the game.
In the game.
It's all in the game.
In the game.
It's all in the game.
Yes, 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 yes.
Mamma mia, mamma mia,
mamma mia, do the screams.
Every team put aside some time to innovate. Innovate. Innovate.
So you think you can fail fast and fail early now?
So you're grooming the backbone bilingually now? Oh, Scrum Master, save us all from disaster.
Never going back, never going back to waterfall.
Points in velocity matter, anyone can see.
Retrospectives matter,
dojo even matters to me.
Thank you.
Oh, good evening. Hopefully you like the introduction there. My name's Harry Dosher. I'm a member of the Agile Center of Excellence here at AT&T. And hold on a minute here. We don't need this guy. Okay. Anyway, I'm a member of the Agile COE here at AT&T, and we're going to be meeting tonight and 10 additional nights to prepare you for the PMI-ACP exam. So always ask questions if you have them. Put things in the chat. you know, raise your hand if you don't understand something, or if there's a comment you want to make. Okay. This is the person you're going to have to put up with for the next 11 nights. So, let me get the slide deck going here. All right. Could everybody hear the video?
Yeah, I could hear it.
Yeah. Hey, yes, sir. Great. One person could hear it.
Yeah.
Yeah, all right.
Well, good.
Good enough. See, we broke the ice. Okay, couple of points we need to make. Right now, unless I send out a new meeting minder, I don't have control to mute the phones. So please, if you're not speaking, go on mute. you can unmute whenever you have you want to ask a question, make a comment, anything like that. Okay. And it's AT&T employees only. So I think Brian vetted everybody. All right. So what we're going to do tonight, and this is going to be a shorter session. This is where the one of the 21 hours comes in. So we'll have just a brief introduction. We'll talk about this workshop, some logistics about the course itself or the workshop. We'll talk about the application process for the ACP exam and give you a little bit of information about the exam itself. We'll cover these things later on too. And then we're going to talk about some of the decisions you need to make and some of the commitments that you need to make. Okay. And all these sessions will be recorded and you'll have access to them. I think it's 30 or 60 days after the workshop's finished. Okay. So back before the beginning, we had a lot of chaos in software development. And Software Engineering Institute at Carnegie Mellon came up with a concept called waterfall. And you know, it was a nice V shape. We started out with requirements and we ended up with system testing and then deployment to the customer. And that was a quantum step forward for software development, especially. But lately though, there's been some thinking about that because software projects would generally take 18 months to 2 years to even longer than that, depending on whether or not there were changes once everything was agreed to. So this is a quote from Stephen Tomke. It was published in the Harvard Business Review in 2012. So we're talking 10 years ago. So Agile is by no means new. Okay. So he's talking about waterfall to begin with. So to avoid making mistakes, teams follow a linear process in which each stage, specification, designing, building, testing, scaling, and launching a product, is carefully monitored at review gates. And we've had this at AT&T. You know, you have to pass a gate before you can move the project forward. So work on the next stage cannot begin until the project passes through the gate. So the project moves down the line, significant commitments are made. The cost of responding to new insights or new requirements increases by orders of magnitude. Okay. I'm sure if you've been involved with the project, have been involved with change control board and change management. Successful tests in late stages are celebrated, and surprises, no matter how valuable they are. If you discover something new, they're considered setbacks. Unfortunately, such a linear process flow can cause project overruns. Because test feedback is delayed, teams cling to bad ideas longer than they should, and problems aren't unearthed until it's expensive to solve them. So what has happened is that we've evolved to using Agile. Okay. So what is the PMI ACP? It's a certification test that tests your Agile expertise and experience. It's given by the Project Management Institute, and they're the people who brought you the wonderful PMP. So there's a nice advertisement for PMI and the ACP that follows that. It's a certification that a growing number of people are getting. So what do you need to acquire this certification? You need 21 hours of instruction. This, what you're sitting through today and the next 10 meetings over 5 weeks is going to be, will satisfy that. Okay, if you, So what you need to do is then register for the exam, take the exam and pass it. Okay. The exam consists of 120 questions. They're all multiple choice. You'll have four possible answers for each one, for each question. You get 3 hours to complete the exam. It's 120, as we said, 120 questions. So you have about a minute and a half per question. So the questions are going to be situational, mostly situational. As a project manager on an Agile project, how, if these certain conditions exist, what would your next step be? Things like that. You may have some definitions on there, you know, that tests your knowledge of some basics, some basic Agile concepts. And there may be one or two formula questions. And if there are any formulas that you have to actually set up and solve, they're going to be whole numbers. They're not going to be anything that you'd need a calculator for. Most of the formula-like questions are going to be testing your knowledge of what that particular formula indicates. And we'll go over a lot of these things in the next several weeks. Okay. Now, your best reference for the exam, any questions about this, will is the PMI website. Okay, we've got a couple of questions here. Will we meet each Monday at the same time? Nope, this is the only Monday that we have. Let me put up the, hold on, let somebody in. Let me put up the schedule here. That's me.
How's it going, sir?
It's going. Huh. Oh, never mind. Never mind. It's in here. Sorry about that. Shoot. Let's share that. Okay, this is the exam schedule, or the workshop schedule. Today's the only Monday. It's every Tuesday and Thursday. You should have received a meeting minder from Brian Berry with the with everything in it. Okay. So what we're going to do tomorrow, we'll have an introduction to Agile. It's a general introduction. Give you the background that you need. Then we're going to cover the seven chapters in the book that I'm going to tell you about in a few minutes here. If you want, take a screenshot of this so that you have the schedule. Now, chapter six is a long one, so we're going to break it into two parts so we don't have to cram everything into a two-hour space. Before breaking it up, we always ran over by at least 15, 20 minutes. That's without questions on chapter six, and it's important material. So we're going to take 2 days to go over that. Okay, at the very end, we're going to have an exam review, and that's an opportunity for you to ask questions. And it's also an opportunity for me to throw a little quiz out there. A little timed quiz. So it's based on the book. So let's okay. Any more questions on the schedule? Okay. Another question. What? Go ahead. Okay. Another question was, this course will cover all the requirements to be able to take the course. No, this workshop is going to cover a lot of the basics in here and some of the advanced topics. The book that we're going to be talking about in a few minutes is your best reference for the exam. The material that's in the book, specifically how it's presented in there, and this would take more than 21 hours to go over in detail. It was written by Mike Griffiths. And guess what? Mike Griffiths was on the committee that developed the ACP exam. So it is he's a good reference for that. Okay. All right. So you're going to have to do a bunch of studying outside of the workshop. Okay. Let's go back. I'm going to take a second here to for Mr. Gates to get the presentation back up. And we talked about that. Okay. Yeah, here's the personal time required. Okay. Each week, you should devote at least 2 hours. I'd suggest a little bit more time to just reading the chapters in the book. And it's best if you can read them before the workshop so that you have an exposure to the concepts, and you can ask questions about that. And we're going to have actually 4 hours of class time each week. And then you're going to need to devote a couple of hours a week to looking at things offline. There'll be you need to do some additional reading, industry type standard stuff, and also take a look on the web for any of the practice exams that are around there too. Okay, any of the practice resources. Okay. And suggestion is, if you want, form some study groups, get together and ask each other questions, go over the concepts outside of class time. Okay. And then there's an application that you have to fill out too. And it isn't trivial. It isn't tough, but it isn't trivial. You've got to document a lot of your experience. So plan on some time with that. Okay. So it's not an insignificant amount of time. So it's going to cost some bucks too. The study guide, this is an old slide. In the last 6 months, it's gone up to around $94. Okay. Testing fees are $435 for PMI members. And if you're not a member, it's an extra $60. So you've got at least around $540 it's going to cost you to take the exam. Okay. And, you know, I've been talking about a book. So here it is. Now, there are three editions out there. Okay. There's a premier edition, there's a second edition, and the one that you want is the updated second edition. Take a screen grab here. I'll write it down. I'll leave it up here for a few minutes. Mike Griffiths is the guy who wrote the book and wrote part of the exam too. So there are plenty of practice questions in this book. And it follows the sections in the exam, the weights, you know, the number of questions approximately for each section in the exam or in the book. It's a really good reference. I mean, mine, I don't know if you can see it, but got a few bookmarks on this thing. Yeah, probably can't see it. But it's hefty too. It's a good foreign object. But I strongly recommend getting the book and reading it before class. Okay. Now, PLE has a basic Agile course. It's a good course. I've gone through it. It has a lot of the good concepts in there. It will reinforce everything that we talk about tomorrow in the introduction to Agile. Okay. The course itself is actually a LinkedIn course, and as AT&T employees, there's no charge for that course if you go through the link here in PLE. Now that reminds me of another thing. I will put a PDF copy of the slides in the chat after every class. So you'll be able to follow along, make notes if you want. Okay. I don't know if we have the ability to provide any mentors. But if there are some dedicated study groups, I may be able to sit in on them, okay, depending on when they're scheduled. Okay. Now, if you want to request a mentor, this link is still good here. And we'll get Brian's attention And I didn't change the slide on there. But this is a good link here for requesting a mentor. Okay. You've got to attend all 11 classes to be able to sit for the exam. There's no real makeup here, and you need all 11 classes to get a certificate. We are going to be using MS Teams, so make sure that it's working fine on your machine. If you're not using your work machine, make sure it's working on your personal machine. Okay. Now there'll be a roster. You can get at it through the PMN webpage. It should be updated, what do they say, 10 days after the workshop date. So you need to check it, make sure that if you did attend, that you get credit for it. Okay, so these links are still good. So the application process. What you want to do is record the number of hours that you've had, in traditional projects and in agile projects. Okay, you need 12 months of general project experience within the last 5 years. If you currently have a PMP certification, that'll satisfy it. It's not required though. So if you were, say, 4 years ago, for the entire year, you were on a waterfall project, that counts. If 4 years ago, you were on 10 waterfall projects in a year, that counts. That's 12 months worth. Okay. You also need 8 months of agile project experience within the last 3 years. Now that's in addition to the 12 months of general project experience. If you had 20 months of agile project experience, that counts for the general and the agile then. Okay, but notice the 8 months of agile project experience has to be within the last 3 years. Okay. If you are on a scrum team, that counts. If you were doing extreme programming, that counts. If you were doing pair programming, that counts. If you were doing test-driven development, that counts. And so if you have any questions about that, bring it to class and we can discuss those types, that type of experience. Okay. And then again, you need the 21 hours of PMN training. Any questions on this? One thing, when you first access the application online, you have 90 days to complete it. Okay. Which should be plenty of time. And then there's a timer that runs. I think you have a year to take the exam. But remember that you lose a lot of the concepts, a lot of the knowledge after about the first 45 days. Okay, what you want to be able to do is go through the workshop, work through the book, read the book, do some studying afterwards, take some tests, get ready for the exam and take the exam as soon as you can after the end of the workshop. So you've got to be working on your application while you're in the workshop too. Now, there are a ton of questions at the end of each of the chapters of the book. There are also online exams. As a matter of fact, rmc.com, the publisher of the PMI ACP exam prep book, I believe has a sample exam out there that you can take. And we've done that in other workshops before, gone through that at the end of the workshop. We've got a little bit different arrangement these days. Okay. Now, it's suggested that you create a spreadsheet for each of the times that you take a practice exam and record your results, okay, so that you have an idea of where you need to study. And what you want to set up is basically a schedule for when you are going to be taking the exam. And again, I will emphasize that it is best to take it as soon as possible after the workshop's completed. And you will get a SPIFFI certificate at the end of this if you have attended all of the sessions. Okay. So, first decision point that you have is, do you have the experience, the right number of hours and the right time frame to be able to apply for the exam? Okay. These are the same dates, 12 months of general project experience within the last 5 years and a minimum of eight months of agile project experience within the last 3 years. What you want to be able to do is commit to taking the PMI ACP exam within 45 days after the workshop ends. That's your best window for taking it. Okay. You're going to need to buy the book, or I don't know, some places you may be able to rent the book. But it is a really good reference. Even after the workshop's done, even after you get an ACP certificate, it is very good reference. Okay. There's that, there's the cost of the exam, and there are also some practice exams are charged for. Some external references are charged for. Okay. And you're going to have to study about 8 hours a week, at least 8 hours a week, to be able to get enough of the concepts and the thought process to be able to successfully take the exam. And it's, sitting through these sessions, for 5 weeks is not going to do it. We can't cover all of the material in the 5 weeks. And then, naturally, the financial commitment to the exam itself. It's AT&T employees only. Doesn't matter if you're management or non-management. You're more than welcome in the workshop. Contractors are not eligible to sit in this workshop. Okay. And again, the workshop should be completed on your own time, not company time. If you're in a time zone where that's not possible, please discuss it with your supervisor. And I haven't heard of anybody getting denied. So it's a good certification. And I've seen a lot of support from management here at AT&T. Now, if you're not a PMN member, I'd suggest you sign up for it. It's free. Okay. the there are a bunch of material on the site itself. There's a really good FAQ out there, so take a look at that first. Okay. And what you want to be able to do is go to the PMI site and review the PMI handbook, because the handbook goes over all the certifications that they offer and what's required for each. There are a whole bunch of things in there. I mean, the biggest thing is that now you're able to take the exam remotely. You can do it in your own home. You can, which is really recommended. Now, the thing is that it's a proctored exam, so that there will be somebody watching you at all times. You're going to have your camera on at all times. Okay. You're not allowed to have anything at all on the work surface. They're going to ask you to pick up your laptop and give them a 360-degree view of the area that you're taking the exam in. Okay. There are no breaks. If you have, you're not allowed to have anything at all. No water, no food, nothing like that. If you have a medical condition that requires you to either have liquids, pills, or be able to, if you have to eat at certain times, you need to contact PMI directly. They're very good to work with. They will work out any accommodations that are necessary. Okay. Realize that I had someone in a previous workshop who mentioned that he had taken the PMP exam remotely. And for some reason, his lips were moving while he was reading the questions. And they stopped the exam on him and asked him to do the 360 and everything, and not to move his lips because he could have been talking to somebody. Okay. Now, if that's really imposing on you, you can always go to a testing center. The links are in the PMI handbook, or they're on the webpage there. Okay. Guess what? That's it. We have time for questions.
Let's see. Can you show slide 28 that was referenced in your prior slide, number 18?
Well, there is no slide 28. Oh, here. That was on a different deck. I apologize for that reference. What it was talking about was this. No. This one. It's the experience here.
So to clarify, the experience means.
I'm sorry, you're breaking up a little bit.
Does the experience need to be a formal or official waterfall project named as such, or agile managed project?
It doesn't have to be named that. They're going to trust that you're not going to try and pull the wool over their eyes. And there's always the chance that they'll audit you too. So if you were on a project, I mean, it's general project experience. If it wasn't waterfall and it wasn't agile and it was a project, then that's project experience.
For the second bullet,
I'm sorry, you're breaking up tremendously on my side. Can you say it again, please?
Minimum of 8 months for the agile project management.
Can anybody hear her?
No.
No, yeah, her condition's
no.
really bad.
Yeah. Maybe she can type it.
Yeah, can you put it in the chat? Now, another thing, you can use any project experience. Say you, ran a fun fair at your kid's elementary school. That's project experience if you plan things out, if you executed it as a project. General project experience if you moved and you laid it out as a project and followed, you ran it as a project, that would count too.
Hey, Harry, I have a question.
Yeah.
So, like the PMP application, it required us to break it down in hours. Is this also hours or is this just time?
This is months. They've revised the PMP also.
Oh, have they?
Okay. So now, it's the same type. You just have months of experience.
Got it. Yeah, that makes sense. It's not so tedious either.
Yeah. Now, if you have overlaps, if you've had, you're working two projects. If you've got the general, like a waterfall project that ran from January to July, and you had an agile project that ran from June to December, that's only 12 months worth of experience. You can't double count any time.
Got it. And you said if you already have your PMP certification, that accounts for the 12 months of general project experience. Then you would just need the 8 months of agile project experience.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I think they'll be lenient with you on that. Now, if you received your PMP within the last 5 years, then you've got that experience. You have to have it for the PMP.
It's sufficient. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. It makes sense.
Leslie, your question was, second bullet states 8 months of agile project experience. Does that have to be a formal agile type project? Or any project generally will satisfy both bullet points? No, the 8 months of agile experience doesn't have to be a formal agile project. If you're using agile methods, they'll count it. So that if it was what we have a lot of at AT&T, we have a lot of projects that are called agile that are really waterfall type, that you use scrum teams, things like that. That would count for an agile project experience. Terrell, I think you might be able to double count if projects were at work and at school. But don't quote me on that. Check with PMI.
Hey, just a heads up. I used to be a PMP instructor for 14 years.
All right.
The red flags, PMI assumes that you have an 8-hour workday. So when you're calculating your projects, think about, that when you're talking about the overlay, multiple projects happening at the same time, you have 8 hours a day, X number per week, X number per month. So you will want to avoid overlap as much as possible, or make sure that you're on the under side for those durations. Yeah, that'll definitely avoid red flags or yellow flags.
Yep. Now, they'll accept it. In the example that I gave, where you had a waterfall project for from January through July, and then you had the agile project from June through December, you can count the June through December as your Agile experience, especially if you've had additional general project experience within the last 5 years. And you just can't count both. And they've changed, again, they've changed from hours to months. Okay. Other questions? Ah, here are some other ones. Do you know if there's an ebook? I do not believe that there is an ebook out there. The physical book is the only thing I've seen. One of the reasons being that there are a lot of illustrations on the pages. That and you know, especially on a small screen, it's going to be extremely difficult. If we do not have the amount of experience, can we still take the course? Yes. The only thing is, if you don't have the experience within the 45 days of taking the workshop, you're probably going to want to take it again. But yeah, you can take the course. I've got no problem with people sitting in on this. I'm surprised nobody asked the biggest question. Will there be music for each class? The answer is yes. There may be some repeats, ones that I really like, but we will have music playing from around the top of the hour until we start at 7 minutes after. That's important. Okay. Well, if there are no more questions, we'll see you again tomorrow evening. Okay, here we go. Here's a good question. If one class is missed due to work requirements, does that negate the entire class completion? For example, work required travel to a client site overlaps the class time. No, that's not going to eliminate you. We're recording these. If you've got a really good reason why you can't come to the workshop when they're scheduled, send me a note. Teams is the best way to get a hold of me. Email is a good fallback, decent fallback, let's put it that way. And just watch the recording, listen to the recording. Okay. That'll be fine. Don't make a habit of it, though. And this is for, you know, legitimate stuff like work responsibilities. If your child or your dog or your significant other gets sick, yeah, take care of them first. Don't worry about the class. We'll figure a way to get you that that time. Okay. All right. Wow. You guys get back. Let's see. Oh. What you want to be able to do. Okay. Do we have to go to the PM? It's the PMN website. It's the AT&T one. To click the roster button after every class. No, that's just to check to make sure. What you want to do is 10 days after the class or the workshop, go out there, just make sure that your attendance has been recorded. That's all. And we've got a small enough class here, I think 10, 12, 14, you know, 15, 20 people at the most, that you know, we can we get the attendance from Teams. So shows how long you were logged in, things like that. So you just want to check it and make sure that everything's okay. If I notice you asking a lot of questions and that, yeah, that makes it easier. I know that that you've been there. And we'll make sure that you get the certificate then. Okay. So don't be shy. Ask questions. Make comments. And enjoy it. Okay. And you get back a little bit over an hour and 6 minutes. And we'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Appreciate
it, Harry.
Hey.
Thank you,
Harry.
Thanks, Harry. Thanks, everybody. You too. Rock on.